In this video, we're going to use truth tables to solve some logic problems. In this problem, we're trying to see if this left-hand side is logically equivalent to the right-hand side, and we can do that using a truth table. If this has the same truth values for all propositions as this one, then they are logically equivalent, or if not, then this statement is false. So one of the first things you do when you're figuring out how many rows and columns you need for a truth table is you figure out how many propositions you have. So in this particular one, you have three. You have P, Q, and R, and a proposition can be either true or false. So P can be either true or false, so there are two possibilities. Q can either be true or false, and R can either be true or false. So you're going to have eight possibilities. So there will be eight rows per column on your truth table, and I went ahead and drew that ahead of time so the lines would be straight. If there were only P and Q, then you would have four rows, and so on and so forth. So the first three rows will just be our three propositions, and we already said that there will be eight rows, so the easiest way to do it is just the first column will have half true and half false, and the easiest way will just be to do the first four as true or false, and then the last four as false in this case. These are not going to be long enough. And then this one will be true, true, false, false, true, true, false, false, and then this last column will always be true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. You don't have to do it that way, but that's kind of the easiest way to remember how to make sure you have a combination for all of them that's unique. And then the next column, you look for any negations. So we're gonna have not Q and not R, but there's no not P. So we're gonna put not Q, not R, and we're basically just working to build up to get this statement and this statement in its entirety. So not Q, you just look at the Q column and put the opposite. So this was true, true, false, false. So you're gonna put false, false, true, true, false, false, true, true. Then not R, you do the same thing, so it's gonna be false, true, false, true, false, true, false, true. And now we have all the individual letters. Next we can group letters, so we have P or not Q, and we're also going to have P or not R. So let me go ahead and fill out the rest of the table in terms of the column headings. So after that we'll have P or not Q and P or not R. Then we'll also have not Q and not R, and we'll have P or Q and not R. And now we can fill in the rest of the table. So we're going to have P or not Q. So we're looking here and here. This column corresponds to this part of the logical statement. For this or, if we have P is true or not Q as true, then this whole statement will be true. So this can be true or false, and this whole statement would still be true. The only way it could be false would be if they were both false. So for this column, we're going to look at P, and we're going to look at the column not Q that we already filled in. So we see here that the way we wrote this, the first four are already true for P. So we can already say that this will be true, 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 regardless of what not Q is. False, false, so that's false. False, false again, so that's false again. And then these bottom two, not Q, are true here. So we're going to get true and true. So for this column, we're going to do the same thing. This column refers to this part of the statement. So again, we're going to look at P, and we're going to look at not R. And if one of them is true, then that whole statement will be true. So again, we know that the first four will be true because P are true for the first four. And then not R, this is false. This is true. This is false. This is true. So we have that column done. This next column is the full statement on the left-hand side, and this combines this statement. So we're going to look at this column, and we're going to look at this column. For this one, this logical symbol is AND. So both these columns have to be true for this whole statement to be true. If one is false, then this whole statement is false. So it's the opposite of this. So these statements are both true, so this is gonna be true. Again, it's true again. True, true, false. We have an F for P or not Q, so that's going to be false. We have one F here, and we have two trues here, so that's true. And now we're done with the left-hand side. Now we're going to work on this right-hand side. So we have not Q and not R, which is this part of the statement. So we're going to look at not Q and not R. And again, because it's and, both of these statements have to be true for the whole thing to be true. So we have false, 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 true, false, 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 true. And now we can fill in the column for the whole right side, which will be looking at this column and P. So you can see that the truth table is basically building up left to right to get these more complex statements in a column. So since we have OR here, either P or this not Q and not R has to be true for the whole statement to be true. So again, we're going to know it's true, 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 true. Then we're going to have false, 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 true. And now we're ready to see if they were logically equivalent or not. So the way we do that is we just focus on the columns that correspond to these two statements. So this is this column, P or not Q and P or not R. And this is this last column here, P or not Q and not R. So if they're the same for all the values, then this statement is logically equivalent. If they're at all different at any row, then they're not equivalent. But we can see when this statement is true, this is true, this is true, true, true. When this is false, this is false. So false, false, false. And then again, we have true, true. So we can see that this will always imply this statement, and this statement always implies that statement because they're always logically equivalent. So this statement is true, and the two statements here are logically equivalent.